I think parking issues is it's really a tough one to get our arms around. You know, we could get into a private partnership and build more parking structures. And we even looked at those, you know, the small lots behind the big parking structures that are over there by Carpenter Center. You know, there's small surface lots there. The last time we built a parking structure, I'm told it cost about $40 million. So we don't have $40 million right now. So what we could do is, as I say, get into a public-private partnership. But then it would be hard to control the rates that would be charged for students and faculty and staff to park in those. Now, you know, we'd have to figure that out, put it in front of people. Are you willing to pay this much more for parking? We are going to build more housing on campus, probably close to 500. We are in regular negotiations with a nonprofit in town called Link Housing to try to get the funding so that part of the new building would be built with affordable housing dollars. So that's in the works, and I think within 2 years we'll be building something. I don't know if it'll be done by that time. The other thing we're doing is the downtown work, where there's a promise for affordable apartments that would be available to faculty, staff, and students who are 21 or older. It's certainly in the plan now to build a multi-story unit around where that single kind of house is that has housing offices. It's over by the organic, the raised bed organic garden. So that's on the master plan as the site. So I know that's going to happen. So I think that the new beach with the A, like the pyramid, it is the kind of singular look. It's just that there's so many other, and then the LB, like that you saw up on the water tower. So that's what I'm hoping. We had a very productive civil discussion over the summer about Prospector Pete. We have, and that has a number of faces. One is obviously the statue. So a group of students, faculty, alumni, and staff all agreed that, you know, Prospector Pete was, you know, kind of passé, and that we didn't need to beat up the alums in the 60s for their lack of understanding about that. But once we were building the Alumni and Visitor Center, the statue will be moved. Well, what's been on my mind is the launch of Beach 2030, our big visioning, strategic planning process. We're putting a lot of, you know, time into that, hoping to involve a lot of people. So I feel the biggest challenge is to make sure that is meaningful. I want to make sure we do it in a way that at the end of the process, 18 months, 2 years from now, people say, you know, not only are we moving in some positive directions, but my voice was heard. I feel like I had some influence or engagement on this. So that's really on my mind, because it would be a terrible waste of time and money and people's, you know, brain power if we kind of ended up with a document that we put on a shelf and so on. So what I'm really hoping is that we all come, including myself, that we come out of this with a, you know, kind of enlarged mindset about how to look around and see what's out there.